OpenLab is a collaboration between the arts and the sciences, where scientists basically are looking for new and innovative ways to present their research in a way that's accessible to the general public. We might know something about visualizing our data in a way that's useful to us scientifically, but we may not know the best way of doing that for presenting to the general public. So the collaboration is about doing that in an effective way.
What happens is the scientists would give a small lecture of what their data is about, and then they sit down and brainstorm how these things could be visualized in whole new ways. All the data that the scientists have gets sent over to the artists, and the artists break that down and turn it into a whole new way of looking at it.
I founded OpenLab as a way to create hybrid practices between art and science, community, design, and technology.
We use a programmer, a fabricator, an electronics person in engineering, somebody who's experiencing gaming. So everybody has a specific role. They come into it with a skill set that then is shared.
So I started working with Jennifer Parker in OpenLab last summer, doing a collaborative project between astrophysicists and artists, essentially. And in the case of this, it's a data representation. It's a visualization of a simulation. And so what we were able to do is then create this as a real model. And so instead of looking at it just on a two-dimensional computer screen, even as a 3D rendering, in this case, you see a three-dimensional animation. So you see this event happening in 3D. So you can look at the front of it and the back of it and the side of it all at the same time as this thing is spinning around.
Our group was working on visualizing tidal disruptions and making that into sort of a game that people could play so they could basically have an interactive version of the galactic center. We just basically combined some movies that I generated from the hydrodynamical simulations that I've run of these disruptions with a Nintendo Wii system. And you only have a certain chance to basically get the star close enough to the black hole where it will be destroyed. But I think just seeing visually what happens, even if you don't really understand exactly what's sort of causing the movies that the people were viewing during the running of the exhibit, at least that gives them some context so that when they go back and maybe read up on it later, they have a picture in their brain of basically what the encounter looks like.
The scientists tend to think in a specific way about their research. By sharing their research with us and seeing the ideas that we come up with, they're then sometimes able to shift their thinking about their own research. We may have a perspective on that, on their research that they haven't thought about, or we may have an idea about a method or a way of showing something which allows them to see something different. And then in seeing something different, they're able to recontextualize their research and take it further.